Welcome to your Ultimate Speakers Buying Guide. In this video, I'm going to cover all the things that you need to know before buying a speaker. So if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Also like and share this video with your friends so that it helps and support my channel. Alright guys, let's get started then. First, let me clear some confusing terms for you, such as hi-fi or high fidelity is what we call. In simple terms, hi-fi audio or high fidelity sound refers to the high quality reproduction of a sound. So meaning when what we hear in real life, for example, the hummingbird sound, how it is reproduced when you listen to it on the hi-fi speaker. So how accurate it is, how accurate the sound reproduction is. So to give that experience, generally hi-fi audio are flat, neutral and of less noise and distortion. So hi-fi doesn't mean it should sound loud and heavy bass, which is a misconception. Second one, stereo versus surround sound. This is very important and can be a deal breaker in choosing a speaker. Should you buy 2, 2.1, 5.1 or 7.1 is again dependent on what you want to listen to. If you listen to movies a lot more than listening to songs on the speakers, then a 5.1 or 7.1 makes more sense. This is because again the home theaters are made to give surround sound with more stress on the center channel, or we can say center speaker, to deliver that true movie watching experience with clearer dialogues, to enjoy that surround sound or high frequency sound effects that can wow your movie experience overall. While if you are into listening to more music, stereo speakers makes more sense. This is because, see, the songs usually in MP3 format, as you know, is a dynamically compressed file where multiple channels is compressed into two channels to give that wholesome listening experience for music, not movies. So a 2 or 2.1 channel speaker is just enough, I will say. 2.1 means one left, one right channel speaker with a subwoofer to give you that extra bass. Alright, now I hope this clears you on where to put your money on. Usually in home theater or 5.1 channel speakers, the sound when produced from multiple channels can be easily divided into different speakers. That is why 5.1, there are 5 channels to divide the frequencies, and hence it is much more suitable to watch movies. The subwoofers can provide low frequency sounds with extra punch to improve listening experience also. Another important thing to look for is the RMS in watts. Do not look at PMPO watts. RMS watts tells you how much power it can deliver continuously, whereas PMPO tells you the peak maximum power output, which can at random times touch the mentioned number and doesn't make any sense considering it. Whereas the RMS tells you that the speaker can output the written RMS on the speaker continuously when you turn to its maximum volume. So, a PMPO is a marketing term again used to fool people into thinking that a small crappy 5 watt RMS speaker can withstand 250 watts of PMPO. So, always check the RMS value of your speakers is my high recommendation. Nowadays, sound bars are getting popular, as you guys know, because it can consume less space and looks sleek and elegant, which can also increase ambience of your living room. Again, if you are buying it to watch more movies than to listen music, then look for soundbar with 2.1 or more, which will have tweeters, subwoofer and full range left and right channel drivers for that proper theater experience. So if you are subscribed to listening to music on TV or connecting wirelessly to your mobile to listen music again, then 2-channel soundbar or 2.1 channel soundbar is just enough. I don't think I have to talk about the features to look for while buying a speaker, because it's again self-deciding factor, like do you want Bluetooth or do you want USB or optical port, etc. Again, it's a personal preference. If it has everything, it's awesome. So Dolby Digital or THX certified speakers sure can deliver a bit better experience, but it has to be a truly certified quality speakers. Otherwise, for example, the THX certified speakers are tweaked and have been certified because it can deliver sound more real to life and how the THX certified movies are designed to deliver that sound. Nowadays, like as you guys know, Dolby Digital is more common, but many cannot deliver the real Dolby turn frequencies with that awesome experience. So look for quality speakers that can actually deliver Dolby audio channels. It all boils down to how and what you enjoy listening to most. Sure, home theaters can give you all-rounded performance for money. Just make sure you buy the quality ones on which you can rely longer. So I will leave a few recommendations if you want in the description section of this video. Based on user experience, you can check them out. If it interests you, you can go ahead and buy. So I hope this video helped you a lot in making purchase decision, and I think I have cleared some of your doubts, most asked questions about buying a speaker. So clearly with that in mind, just go ahead and buy the speaker, quality speakers in your budget. Like I said, I'll leave a link in the description section of this video for my recommendation. That will be my personal recommendation. It doesn't have to be a quality and awesome experience, but still based on user experience, I will throw in some links that you can check them out. Yeah guys, see you all in another one. Don't forget to click on that subscribe button and hit that like button and do share it with your friends. See you all in another one. Till then, take care. Bye bye.